Hello, hello. Good evening, everybody. Hello, Lorenita. How are you today? It's good to
Hi,
have you
teacher.
here, my dear. We are about to finish.
I'm
Congratulations.
glad to see you too.
I'm glad to see you too. Okay, we are going to expect that more people can join us, Lorenita.
Okay.
So we are going to start sharing the platform, and I would like to ask, first of all, have you completed or almost completed the platform? I remember that you told me that you already did even the final test.
Yes, I finished last week.
Okay.
And also I got my
Your diploma?
o cómo se dice, ajá,
Your
sí.
certification or your diploma?
Yes.
Okay,
I have
excellent.
some question about that because the date in the diploma are in the past.
Which
Dice
date?
25 de agosto. Dice duración del curso de julio a agosto.
Maybe you should ask Jonathan, because maybe there's a mistake. Okay.
Okay,
You tell him, because if there's a mistake, they should correct it. You know, for example, if you have to present, yes, if you have to present any documentation to your work, for example, if in your workplace they require the diploma, and this is gonna have any difficulty because it differs from the date that you really took the course, you should ask him, right?
okay.
Okay,
Okay.
it could be nice.
Okay.
Okay, excellent. So, welcome, Roberto. How are you today, my dear?
Hi, teacher. Hi, Lorena.
To have you here.
Hi, Roberto. Good
I would
evening.
like to know, Roberto, good evening. I would like to know if you have been able to work in the platform or if you have still pending some exercises, if you have questions so far.
No.
No?
I, pero ¿cómo se dice? I do, o no sé, hacer. Yo he hecho hasta la sección 4.
Okay, you have advanced until section 4. So it's good. So the idea is that by this Friday, you can complete section number 5. So that's
Okay.
why I would like to ask you to please try to do it. And if in case you need support, I will be here just pending in the chat in order to help you, right? Because they are going to close the platform. They are going to finish the platform. As I read in the chat, they said that by Friday. Okay.
Okay.
So that's why I would like to see if you can look for the complexion of the section 5. And if you have any difficulty, then I can help you, of course. Okay.
Okay, teacher. Thanks.
Excellent. Good. Perfect. So for today, we are going to advance in the 5.11 lesson objective that says that by the end of this class, you will learn vocabulary for discussing school, in this case, school vocabulary. Okay. And we are going to talk about this. We are going to have this vocabulary in the video. You can watch more vocabulary for you to continue practicing. And then we are going to cover the 5.13. By the end of this class, you will develop skills in scanning and reading for specific information and sequencing events. This is going to be tomorrow, I think, because today we are going to continue and complete the practice we missed yesterday about a conversation. And tomorrow we are going to cover this scanning for information and sequencing events. We are going to learn some key words in order to identify sequencing. But by now, I'm going to stop and I'm going to move you to the practice we missed last night, and then we will go to the school vocabulary. Okay, if you remember last night, we learned how to ask questions in past using was and where, but also using the auxiliary did, right? So we basically work in WH questions in past with the verb be, and WH questions in past with any other verb, it means using did, right? So we learn the difference between them, how to separate them, how to identify them, and so on. And we also solved this exercise, but it was pending to complete this part that for me is very important, because remember that this is the only one chance that you have to speak. I mean, if you see the platform is the key in order to pass the course, so you have to go to the platform and do the exercises, but in order for you to improve your speaking, this is your chance to come to the class and speak, okay? So what we're gonna do now is to start asking some questions. For example, what did you drink and eat for breakfast today? If you see in this case, we're using did as an auxiliary, right? What, WH, what did you drink and eat for breakfast today? So let me ask you, okay, for example, if you ask me, teacher, what did you drink and eat for breakfast today? I can say, okay, I every morning drink a coffee. If I don't have coffee, I cannot wake up. So, but in this case, I use the past. I say, I drank. Mm-hmm. I drank a coffee, right? And I ate one sunny side up egg with cheese and fried bananas. Okay? So, fijan, dije, I ate. I drank, because I gave an answer with an affirmative sentence. ¿Sí? Utilicé el did para la pregunta, ¿verdad? Por eso mi verbo quedó en presente. Drink, eat. Aquí tengo dos verbos. ¿Verdad? What did you drink and eat? Entonces este did está afectando, ¿verdad? En términos de indicar pasado para el verbo drink y para el verbo eat. Entonces, la pregunta se traduciría, ¿qué tomaste o qué bebiste y qué comiste para el desayuno hoy? Pero cuando yo doy la respuesta, yo digo, como ya no voy a tener un auxiliar, ¿verdad? Porque voy a dar respuesta en oración afirmativa, yo digo, I drank, verbo en pasado, drank, bebí o tomé café, I drank coffee, y digo, I ate. Como el número 8, ¿verdad? El pasado de comer es casi igual en la pronunciación que 8. I ate. Y digo lo que comí, ¿verdad? Eggs, bananas, fried bananas, and cheese. Okay, look, next question. What did you watch on TV last weekend? Okay, solo se la voy a leer. No se preocupen. Les voy a dar más tiempo para que lo piensen y para que organicen la pregunta. Vean. Recuerde que en este caso el did está afectando al verbo watch, ¿verdad? ¿Qué viste? Cuando yo responda,
watched,
¿verdad? Y tenemos que recordar la regla de cómo pronunciamos, ¿verdad? Los pasados, en este caso es un regular verb, y tenemos que terminan en T, ED, y en TD, en ED, ¿verdad? Esas son las tres pronunciaciones. How old were you when you first rode a bike? Okay. How old were you? ¿Cuántos años tenías when you first rode a bike? ¿Cuándo montaste una bicicleta? Rode a bike. Okay. So you have to think about your age when you rode a bike. What did you buy recently? Did you buy? ¿Qué compraste recientemente? Okay. Entonces, cuando yo responda, yo tengo que decir I y el pasado del verbo bought, ¿verdad? Y cuando en la anterior, how old were you, yo tengo que decir I was, ¿verdad? Porque cuando para decir yo tenía tantos años, cuando yo lo digo en presente, yo digo I am 40 years old, for example. But if I'm going to say in the past, I say, I was. Mm-hmm. I was 10 years old when I rode a bike by the first time or whatever. Okay. Number, let's see, next. What did you make for dinner yesterday? So when you answer, you say, I made. O también puedo responder con I cooked. ¿Verdad? Si usted quiere utilizar otro verbo, un sinónimo, usted puede decir I cooked. Where did you go on your last vacation? Entonces aquí cambio mi verbo go a went, ¿verdad? In my last vacation, I went to. Went to. Ese es to siempre va por, antes de mencionar el lugar, ¿verdad? Where did you go after school or work yesterday? Okay. So when I answer, I say after school when. Or after work yesterday, I went to. Fui a. ¿Verdad? Who did you see before class? ¿A quién viste antes de la clase? You can say, I saw, ¿verdad? Cambio al pasado. I saw my family, I saw my mom, I saw whoever, okay? So the idea is that you can create short conversations based on this. So welcome, Carlita. It's a pleasure to have you here, my dear. Welcome. So I'm going to join you. Lo voy a unir en un grupo a los tres in order that you can practice, right? That you can practice at least one question and one answer each person. I think that you will have the chance to practice at least two. ¿Verdad? Van a tener el tiempo de practicar por lo menos dos preguntas por cada persona y dos respuestas, ¿verdad? Okay, because we have 2, 4, 6, 8, and we are 3, so it's 2 is okay. Do you have questions so far? ¿Tenemos preguntas?
No, teacher.
Okay, excellent. So I'm going to send you to the breakout room in order that you can relax and you can have more time to elaborate what you're going to do. Okay. Okay, so let me stop share. I'm going to send you the picture. If you can take a picture, it's okay. But I'm going to send it to you. And then... Okay, let me see. Okay, we will have 5 minutes in order to practice. And then we will come back to the plenary and have feedback. Okay, so let me send you to one and let's create the room. Okay, please join my dears. Por favor, únanse para que puedan practicar. You decide which questions you would like to answer. Usted decide qué preguntas le gustaría preguntar y responder. Roberto, my dear, do you have a problem joining?
Comer. No, I watched. Y tiene que decir, ¿ve?
Por ejemplo, juntas.
El programa, la película.
Ah, ok. Moama.
What? Ajá. What did you watch? I watched Moana.
Moana, Moana.
Pues yo, ¿verdad?
Or where you when you fit shoes and bike?
I was, I don't remember, about 6 or 7 years old. And Roberto, what did you buy recently?
Boat. Con T, boat, porque si le ponen Z es como ambos, both. Entonces, boat.
Ok. I bought a cell phone.
Pues chica, este Robert tiene pisto. Come pupusas, jugo de naranja.
Huawei.
Ya ves, último modelo.
Ok. Entonces, Carla, what did you make for dinner yesterday?
Okay, made ay, ¿cómo se dice? ¿Cómo puedo decir? Cena, vea.
Dinner. Sí, vea. Cena. I made dinner. I cooked. En ese caso puede cambiar a cooked. I cooked. Okay. Y puede decir el plato que cocinó.
Ah, ok, ok, ok. Uh-huh. Entonces sería I could steak grill.
Yes. A grilled steak.
Tiene pisto también, ya ves. De no carnita asada.
Como casamiento. Como casamiento o algo.
Casamiento.
It doesn't have a translation. But uh-huh. when you want to explain, you can say it's like mixed of
beans and rice.
Beans and rice. Beans and rice. Uh-huh. For example, tortilla. You cannot translate tortilla because uh-huh. there's no translation. But you explain.
Ni pupusa. No, ni horchata.
It's a mixture of corn flour in a round uh-huh. way, right? Rounded. Entonces usted trata de explicar, ¿verdad? ¿En qué se trata? Just in case people don't know and they say, oh, what's that dish about? ¿Cómo, de qué se trata ese plato, verdad?
Okay. Entonces sería, I could grill steak uh-huh. and meat, uh-huh. fins, and ¿cómo es arroz?
In a mixture of beans and rice. Okay.
Beans and rice.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. Next question.
Okay. Where did you go on your last vacation?
I went to Monterrey City. Roberto, where did you go after work yesterday? Sí, porque no creo que vaya a la escuela, a la universidad. Bueno, no sé, vea. Where did
class.
You go after school or work yesterday?
Okay. I went to the restaurant
Ya decía yo.
Okay. Solo de billete.
Yeah. A rich man. Okay. It's a joke. Okay.
Okay. Carla, who did you see before class?
En la TV, dígale.
Ajá. Who did you see?
Ay, who? No sé.
I you can say I saw my family, I saw my, I don't know, my mom, I saw my husband.
I saw my family.
Okay, excellent. Very good. Okay, next question.
It's over, teacher.
Okay.
There's no more questions.
Okay, but I heard that you already practiced. The idea was that you can practice and identify that in a question, the verb remains in simple present, right? Because you use the auxiliary did. But when you provide the answer, since you use an affirmative sentence, you have to change it to the past of that verb, okay? Excellent, very good. So let me go back. Vamos a regresar al main room in order that you can continue with the class, okay? Mute myself. Okay. In order to continue, since I heard you, I won't ask you to repeat the questions, right? That's why I moved to the room. Como ya los escuché, no les voy a pedir que repitan, ¿verdad? Las preguntas, porque ya escuché que en efecto hicieron el ejercicio. Okay, now I have this interesting exercise, which is a little bit different. What you have to do now is, for example, here you have that a WH question. A structure is WH word plus did plus the subject plus the base form of the verb. So for example, you say, why did you leave early? How did they meet the beach? They meet at the beach. How did they meet at the beach? So those are questions. But now here I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Almost 10. I think they are 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Okay. In simple past. Okay. Now it's the way you did. Aquí están en la forma a la que ustedes acaban de hacer sus respuestas, ¿verdad? Estas son unas oraciones afirmativas. Affirmative sentences in simple past. Estas son oraciones afirmativas en pasado simple. They saw a good movie last week. We read an interesting book. I shut the window because it was, because it was cold. They planted a young tree. The mouse ate the yellow cheese. The pupils cleaned the backyard. My brother visited my uncle. The baby cried because it was hungry. The teenager talked to his friend. This bird flew to Africa. Okay, all of them are simple past affirmative sentences or statements. So what we are going to do now is to change them into questions, okay? Lo que vamos a hacer ahora es cambiarlo a pregunta. Ustedes dirán, teacher, pero ¿por qué ir y venir? Because I want that you can get the competence of knowing how to ask and answer questions in past. ¿Verdad? La idea de este juego de ir de una forma a la otra es para que ustedes adquieran la competencia de identificar, escribir y pronunciar oraciones en pasado simple, pero también preguntas, ¿verdad? Y de identificar cómo trasladar una afirmación a una pregunta and vice versa, ¿ok? So, let me take the picture, and if you can take one, it's going to be okay. Vamos a ver. Vamos a tomar una imagen. Si usted le puede tomar una mejor, it's perfect. So, just let me Okay. So I'm going to send it to you. And I would invite you to go again to the breakout rooms. Okay, so the idea is that you can discuss and that you can change them. Okay, so let me open the breakout room again. And then.
I'm sorry.
Don't worry, I understand. It's very tiring. Yo sé que es cansado, Ms. Lorena. And I congratulate you because of this effort, and I appreciate that. So we are about to finish in just like a couple of minutes. Minutos, okay? Okay, you can start now. You can join. That's why I would like that you can work together. Por eso quiero que trabajen juntos, ¿verdad? Porque si solo me escuchan a mí, se me duermen.
El verbo es so en pasado, el en presente tiene que ser sí. What did they see? O
what did they see last week?
What did they see last week? Digo yo, they saw a good movie.
Mm-hmm. What did they see?
Uh-huh. Oh, or what did they do?
No. Puede ser so. And in this case, what did they see? What did they see last week? O podrían haber utilizado
what
did they watch last week? Pero sure. En este caso estamos usando so, entonces lo vamos a pasar a presente porque en la pregunta vamos a utilizar el auxiliar did.
Okay.
Okay.
What is the difference between see and watch in this case?
Okay. See, it's like see you tomorrow, te veo mañana, verte. But watch is like observing, for example, right now you're watching your screen, ¿verdad? Es mirar, estoy mirando con algún detenimiento, con alguna mayor fijación o cuidado. For example, this applies for TV. I'm watching TV, I'm watching my cell phone, right? I'm watching a movie. I'm watching you, pero es como te estoy observando, ¿verdad? Te estoy mirando con detenimiento. Sí, es como te veo, pero sin mayor reparo, ¿verdad? Es I see you tomorrow. Te veo mañana, pero no te estoy mirando fijamente. Entonces, esa es la diferencia entre see y watch. ¿Ya? When you say I'm watching television, es porque usted está dedicado un tiempo, carefully, cuidadosamente, a verlo. Uh-huh. A mirarlo con detenimiento. Y with attention. Okay. Uh-huh. Excellent.
Okay, number two. We read an interesting book.
Mm-hmm. Where are they?
What did
we?
What?
No, we.
We.
What did we? No, acuérdense, el WH. Uh-huh. El what did we read?
What did we read? Hasta ahí, ¿verdad?
That, uh-huh. What did we read? Uh-huh.
And the answer is?
We read
an interesting book.
Interesting book.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Okay.
Okay, excellent.
Third one.
I
shut the window because it was cold. Why did you? El shut es igual, ¿verdad, teacher? En los tiempos.
Shut es como cerrar o bajar. For example, the computer. Would you like to shut down? Shut down. No es shut, es shut. Shut down. Okay. Shut down es como una U casi A. ¿Verdad? El sonido se llama schwa. Uh-huh.
Pero es de esos verbos que no cambian, presente, pasado.
Sí, exacto. I shut down because it was cold. Entonces, este verbo se mantiene igual, ¿verdad? Entonces sería did why? It's a reason.
Why? Why did you shut?
Why did you?
Shut.
The window.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and the answer is there because it was cold. Okay, excellent. Next.
They planted a young tree.
They planted.
What? Planted. What did they plant?
They plant.
Mm-hmm.
What did they plant?
Excellent.
Next. The mouse ate the yellow cheese. Roberto lo quiere hacer.
Cinco, dos, cuatro.
Sorry.
Don't worry.
Mouse ate the yellow cheese.
Okay. What mouse eat?
What did the mouse eat? What did the mouse eat?
Okay. The mouse ate the yellow cheese.
Excellent. Very good.
Cleaned the backyard.
Mm-hmm.
The pumpkin cleaned the backyard. What did the pupil clean?
Pupil.
Así se dice pupil.
Pupil. Mm-hmm. ¿Qué es pupil?
Los pupilos, como las personas que arrendan el lugar. Mm-hmm. Como los inquilinos, digamos.
Okay.
Excellent.
My brother visits my uncle. Who did my brother? Dele.
Who did my brother visit?
Mm-hmm.
My brother
visited. Acuérdense que el pasado de visit. Que visit termina con T, entonces para pronunciarlo en el pasado es visited.
Teacher, y usted no tiene visited. Listado que diga cómo se pronuncia.
Se lo mandé. Ah, no,
les mandó. Es que no, nos mandó
como no
los irregulares para que nos lo aprendiéramos.
Pero les mandé esa presentación.
La de las reglas.
Sí, la de las reglas, ya les digo. Perdón que interrumpa, pero quiero que le chequear. Ahorita les digo cuando se los mandé. Si no, yo se los reenvío ahorita. Les mandé los verbos irregulares y también les mandé esa presentación en fecha 6 de octubre. Uh-huh. Voy a intentar reenviarla.
Gracias, Tich.
Vamos a ver si lo puedo
reenviar. Sorry for the interruption.
No se preocupe. Ok. Ahí está. Solo asegúrense que ahí está.
Okay.
Okay, perfect.
Okay.
Next. There it is.
The baby cried because it was hungry.
Yeah, who? Who did?
No, why?
Why? Why did?
Why did the baby cry?
Cry.
Pero, yes, why did the baby cry? ¿Por qué lloraba el bebé?
Mm-hmm. The next one. The teenager talked.
Acuérdese que la L no suena. Talked.
The teenager talked to his friend.
The teenager
talked to his friend. Who did the teenager talk?
Mm-hmm. Very good.
Who did the teenager
talk? And the last one?
This bird flew to Africa. Where did these birds fly?
Uh-huh. Where these birds fly? Where did these birds fly? Excellent. Very good, my dears. Congratulations.
Fly, flew, flown.
Okay. Excellent. Very good. You did a great job by changing these simple, these affirmative sentences in simple past into WH questions. Okay. So I'm going to stop sharing and we will go back to the break to the main room in order to continue with the last part. So let me just close. Okay, just let me take you back in time. We already closed that part of WH word questions in past and yes, no questions in past. And now let's start with this topic that we are going to finish tomorrow, but I would like to introduce some of this vocabulary in order that tomorrow we can finish together with the midterm final exam. So in a platform, you have a video which is about school subject and classes and all that vocabulary. So for example, the most common subjects in class are English, language arts, mathematics. Mathematics, you can abbreviate math, but the full name is mathematics, science, social studies, foreign languages. In foreign language, it will depend. It can be English, it can be French, it can be Italian, depending, right? Other classes and college credits, okay? College credits. So some vocabulary of the places in school are, for example, the schoolyard, the principal's office, the classroom, the music room, the art room, the computer room, the library, and the lockers, okay? And for example, I have some questions for you. What was your favorite subject in school? If you ask me, I can say my favorite subject in school was language, right? And if you ask me, why, teacher? Why language was your favorite subject in school? I can say, because I learned to improve my Spanish, okay? If you improve your own language, it's highly probably you can have better understanding of other languages. Who was your best friend at school? My best friend at school was, let's say, Marlene, a friend of mine at school. Who was your favorite teacher in school? Well, actually, I didn't have a favorite teacher, but let's say that we have a very good teacher whose name was Rita. When did you finish high school? I finished high school in 1996. I finished, okay? High school in 1996. Where was located your school? My school was in San Salvador. Okay, so I would like that you can think about these questions. And for tomorrow, we are going to elaborate a more complete conversation about these topics, okay? So if you see, now we are putting into practice in real life conversation, WH question, right? In this case would be, what was your favorite subject in school, right? ¿Cuál fue o cuál era, verdad? In this case, I'm using was because I'm talking about cero estar in past. ¿Cuál fue? ¿Cuál era? Okay. What was your favorite subject in school? ¿Cuál era tu asignatura favorita en la escuela? Okay. Next question. Who was your best friend at school? ¿Quién era o quién fue tu mejor amigo, verdad, en la escuela o en el colegio? Next question. Who was your favorite teacher in school? De nuevo, ¿verdad? Who was? ¿Quién era? When did you finish school? Vea, aquí ya no estamos hablando del verb be. Y entonces cambio y tengo que utilizar el did como auxiliary para decir when did you finish? Porque aquí el verbo principal es finish. ¿Cuándo finalizaste? When did you finish school? ¿Cuándo finalizaste la escuela? And again, I come back, regreso con el was, porque estamos diciendo estaba. Where was located your school? ¿A dónde estaba ubicada? Located, ubicada, localizada. Where was located your school? Okay, so let's think about these questions. Oops, excuse me. And I would like that in addition to these questions, you can have like a short paragraph saying this. When I was in school, my classmates and I were. So the homework is, let us share a funny school story. Use the past tense, okay? Lo que vamos a hacer es compartir una historia divertida o graciosa de algo que nos haya pasado en la escuela, ¿verdad? You can start by saying, when I was in school, my classmates and I were. Cuando yo estaba en la escuela, mis compañeros y yo éramos o estábamos, ¿verdad? And remember that you can use verbs like, I was, we were, they were, she was, it was, okay? Or you can use the did to make some questions with other verbs or the verb in simple past. For example, if I say, when I was in school, my class and I, let's elaborate a little bit more. And let me write here my story for you just to have an idea. When I was in school, my classmates and I were very happy. Because we did not have, vamos a usar el full, ¿verdad? Aunque podría haber dicho we didn't have, pero como estoy escribiendo, vamos a usar el full. Okay. Because we didn't have so many responsibilities. We only worried about getting good marks. Okay? We had nice time during the break. During the breaks. We used, vean, este es un verbo que utilizamos mucho cuando hablamos en pasado. We used to play very traditional games of chasing each other. We can say soccer, basketball, or simply chat and laugh for a long time. Okay? We have excellent teachers that I remember. Until today, we had so nice sharing times together. And I missed that beautiful times. See, now I have a mixture. If you see, now I have a mixture of simple past, present, and so on. Okay? Si ustedes ven, ahora yo tengo una mezcla. Perdón que escribí todo en mayúsculas, ¿verdad? Para ir un poco más rápido. Pero si usted se fija, ahora yo tengo una mezcla de pasado, presente, ¿verdad? Pero estoy evocando un hecho del pasado. Normalmente cuando yo empiezo una historia del pasado, yo digo, when I was 10 years old, etc. O when I was in school, or when I was at the university. Vean, aquí digo, my classmate and I were very happy. Y continúo hilvanando la misma idea, ¿verdad? ¿Por qué éramos felices? Because we didn't have so many responsibilities. Vea, aquí ya yo estoy mezclando una oración negativa. Pero estoy con mi relato, ¿verdad? ¿Por qué éramos felices? Porque no teníamos tantas responsabilidades. We only worried. Y aquí ya va una sola mezcla de verbos regulares e irregulares, ¿verdad? Aquí, si se fijan, estoy utilizando un verbo regular. We only worried about getting good marks. Vea, aquí estoy utilizando un presente, un pasado continuo. We only worried about getting good marks. Solo nos preocupábamos de obtener buenas notas. We had nice times, or we had, yes, nice times during the breaks. We had, teníamos bonitos momentos, ¿verdad? During the breaks. We used to. Este we used to se utiliza mucho cuando hablamos en pasado para decir solíamos, acostumbrábamos, ¿verdad? Ese es el we used to. We used to play very traditional games. Solíamos jugar juegos muy tradicionales. Of chasing each other, de perseguirse uno al otro. Soccer, basketball, or simply chat and laugh for a long time. ¿Verdad? Fútbol, basketball, o simplemente conversar y reír por mucho tiempo. We had, tuvimos, we had excellent teachers that I remember until today. ¿Vean? Aquí estoy haciendo dos tiempos. We had excellent teachers. Ahí termina una idea. Tuvimos excelentes maestros that I remember until today. Que yo recuerdo, eso ya es presente, ¿verdad? Que yo recuerdo hasta hoy. We had so nice sharing times. Tuvimos tiempos, tuvimos, we had, es otro verbo que se utiliza mucho cuando estoy contando un relato. O podríamos haber dicho we spent, ¿verdad? En lugar de we had, podríamos haber dicho we spent nice time together, ¿verdad? Pero aquí yo dije, we had some nice sharing times together. O podríamos haber dicho, we had some nice, vamos a ver, we had some nice time together. O podría haber dicho también, we spent. En este caso es un verbo irregular en pasado, we spent many celebrations together. Ok, lo dejé para no repetir nuevamente together. We had some nice time to get times together. We spent many celebrations and I missed that beautiful times. ¿Vea? We spent many celebrations. Pasamos juntos muchas celebraciones y regreso al presente. And I miss that beautiful times. Y extraño esos tiempos hermosos. So if you see, it's not just simple past. The idea is that you learn how to combine simple past, but also present, right? And little by little, you will acquire that competence, okay? Esta es una competencia que poco a poco ustedes la van a ir adquiriendo, ¿verdad? No los quiero abrumar, pero el nivel al que ustedes van, que ya serían los intermedios, si no estoy mal, poco a poco van a ir, ¿verdad? Avanzando y van a ir haciendo como ya estas combinaciones de diferentes tiempos, ¿verdad? Verbales. Y pueden comenzar con párrafos chiquitos como esto, ¿verdad? So I decided to show you my experience in order that you can build your own. Decidí traerles esta experiencia, ¿verdad? Cortita, chiquita, un párrafo pequeño para que ustedes traten de hacer la suya para mañana. Maybe you were little angels. Maybe you were a little bit, joyful people. Or maybe you did some very terrific things, right? Vamos a ver si eran angelitos, ¿verdad? O si eran un poco más terriblitos, ¿verdad? Por eso puse ahí unos animalitos, porque pueden resultar mis historias también así un poco terroríficas, ¿verdad? Okay, do you have questions so far? ¿Tenemos preguntas hasta acá?
No, teacher.
Okay, so for tomorrow, the idea is that you can remember about your time in school and that you can share. Right, a short story about it, okay? So, thank you very much for coming. Remember that tomorrow, after this part of the class, we are going to review the pending knowledge check, and we are going to review the final exam, okay? Hope to see you tomorrow. Be safe and have a good rest, okay? Good night.
Good night.
See you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Don't worry. Sorry. I understand. Don't worry. Bye-bye. Take care. See you.